In this video tutorial, we will create Power BI paginated reports using SQL Server database. Paginated reports are designed to be printed or shared. They're called paginated because they're formatted to fit well on a page. They display all the data in a table, even if the table spans multiple pages. Paginated reports also include charts, which are created using Chart Wizard. In this video, we will create both the tabular report as well as a chart report. In this video, we will also show you how to connect to the SQL Server database using data source and data set in Power BI Report Server. We will use the following data stored in Microsoft SQL Server to create our paginated report. Let's take a quick look at the data. The data contains sales by products and regions. The first step is to connect Power BI Report Server to SQL Server database. This can be done by creating a new data source. In the connection string, we will provide the IP address and the port number of the SQL Server. This information can be copied from SQL Server Management Studio. We also need to provide user ID and password to access the SQL Server database. This user ID and password must belong to a user with network authentication. We also need to provide the name of the database which we want to access. Finally, we can test the connection to confirm if our connection string is working. If the connection is successful, we can click on the Create button to create the data source. We can modify a data source at any time by using the More Info button. After creating a data source and connecting to the Microsoft SQL Server successfully, we must create a data set to extract information from SQL Server database. A data set is created in the Report Builder. To create a data set, we must first select a data source from the list of data sources or browse for one if not listed. Then, we must click the Create button. In the data set window, we must select the table which we want to use in our paginated report. After selecting the table, we must save the data set. we can move an object to another location, using the More Info button. We can preview the data in Report Server, by selecting a data set. If paginated report can be created from the new button. Paginated reports are created in the report builder. Let's create a tabular report first. We need to select a data set, we can also browse for one. Now we need to place fields in the column groups, row groups, and values area, to create a paginated report. We will show the regional information in columns, and the product information in the rows. The cost and the sales fields must go to the values area. There are three types of reports, from which we can choose one. We can also have expand collapse buttons for groups. After we finish the wizard, Report Builder will display the design of our report. We can still make changes to our report, using the Report Builder. Let's refresh the page to display our report. Our report will appear in Paginated Reports group. We can click the report, to view, print, and export the report in other formats. Our report is 2 pages long. At the end of the last page, there are the grand totals. Let's create another paginated report, using the new button. However, this time, we will create a chart report. We will choose the yearly sales data set, which is already created. There are 5 types of charts we can create. We will create a column chart. We will display years as categories, and the sales and units as values. Once we finish the chart wizard, we will be taken to the report builder, in design view, where we can make further changes. After making necessary changes, we can save the report, and close the report builder. The report will appear after we refresh the browser. Our report is here. Let's open the report and see how it looks like in Report Server. It's a simple printable chart, which can be exported to other formats such as PDF, or can be printed on paper. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.